Okay. In 1965, a Harvard psychologist by the name of Robert Rosenthal rocked up at an elementary school offering them a new test of intelligence. He called it the Harvard Test of Acquired Acquisition. Called it the Harvard Test of Inflected Acquisition and said that it would accurately predict which students would excel most in the following year. Of course, the school agreed. The kids took the test. Mr. Rosenthal comes back and he identifies this group of students that are going to excel. Even though these kids might not have performed well in previous years, they had the magic fairy dust that was going to allow them to excel from this point on. The teachers are informed which children are the chosen ones, and Rosenthal goes on holiday, does other Harvard stuff, and he comes back a year later, and wow, would you believe it, they've done fan-dabby-dozy. In fact, on average, the children that were identified as the smarty pants that year gained an average of 27 IQ points. That's in comparison to an average of 12 points that were gained by the children that were not the chosen ones. They were described by their teachers to be more curious, happier, better adjusted, and that they anticipated that those children would continue to do well. So how do you see if your child has the magic secret sauce this year? You don't, because the thing about this test was that it was bogus.
You are fake news.
These high potential students were chosen completely at random. The real test wasn't about these 20% high achievers or the secret sauce that they had. The real test was a study on how narratives affect the relationships between people, between the students and the teachers, and what impact that has. Here, the narrative being that the teachers now believed in the potential of those children. What happened, Rosenthal discovered, was that that belief held by the teachers created a cascade of behaviors in the teachers that significantly affected the outcome for the child. The teachers gave those children more time, more often, listening more carefully. They provided more materials, they gave more feedback, and they gave children the benefit of doubt in ambiguous situations. They were kinder, more connected, and their relationships with the children improved. There was a virtuous circle of sorts. And it wasn't bold leaps that made the difference, it was tiny interactions, the nuances that collectively shifted the dial. When we expect certain behaviors in others, we are likely to act in ways that make the expected behavior more likely to occur. I.e., your belief in your child is a self-fulfilling prophecy. It's not some wishy-washy idea, it's science. It's fundamental, like gravity. Believing is seeing. It's also critical to appreciate that there is a compound interest that your child will earn because of your belief in them. In the mid-1980s, a Canadian psychologist by the name of Roger Barnsley came across something very interesting whilst watching ice hockey with his wife. Looking at the roster, they realized that most of the players were born in January, February, or March. He did some research. He found that 40% of professional hockey players in that league were born in the first 3 months. 30% were born between April and June. 20% between July and September, and just 10% between October and December. What they were seeing was the result of a great head start. In Canada, the school year begins in January, and separated into year groups, it was the oldest children that were being identified as gifted and talented. The reality is they were just bigger and stronger, and the younger kids were neglected. They'd be the ones that were fast-tracked onto the All-Star programs where they were given the best coaching, support, and opportunities. Soon enough, they are really better, and no surprise, they go on to become the professionals. It's kind of crazy to think about how many children fell through the gaps because they were born too late. How many Wayne Gretzky's fell through the... Wayne Douglas Gretzky, born January 26th. We just found that out together. Thank goodness for that. If he was born in October, it would have ruined this whole thing. He absolutely struck gold with the birthday lottery. What talent was lost? How many Wayne Gretzky's are out there working in McDonald's because they didn't get the support that they needed to when they were seven? The takeaway that I want you to have today can be best summed up by a sociologist by the name of Robert Merton, wonderfully researched. He coined the phenomenon of the Matthew effect, named in reference to the Gospel of Matthew. For unto everyone that hath shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from him that hath not shall be taken away. In other words, the rich get richer. The teacher, the parent, believing is seeing. Let's champion our kids to be awesome every day. Science. Interestingly, going back to Rosenthal, he also did a study with rats. He took clever rats and stupid rats. They were the same rats. He gave them to his researchers and said, see how well the clever rats do in the mazes. See how well the dumb rats do. Which ones did the best? The clever rats. The explanation being, just like the kids, those rats were treated with more respect, more kindness. They were handled with more care. Treat your kids like good rats. Give them a rat wheel. That's all I have to say today. Until next time, stay awesome and keep being you.